career began 28 years ago when he was the ring announcer for his third grade elementary school circus. So he is a pro, let me tell you. Over 14 years experience in training salespeople to enhance your productivity, sales skills, efficiency, tech awareness, and tech savviness. Please help me welcome Mr. Jeremiah Smitter.
Good morning, good morning, good morning. Can everybody hear me okay? All right, so welcome to Tech Tools for Real Estate. It wouldn't be Tech Tools if it didn't have a tech problem. Okay, starting with that. And we have locked the doors, so now yous can't leave. All right, I'm from New York. That's how we treat you. We're going to keep you in here, get you outside your comfort zone a little bit. And like she said, my speaking career began 28 years ago when I said, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, welcome to the Kirk Road Circus. And from then on, I've always been on the stage in front of people talking, doing something fun. But today we're going to get you outside your comfort zone, because you can either rise to your potential or sink to your comfort. Okay, think about that as we go through today. And my goal is, who's excited about that? Okay, some of you need to tell your faces. I can't see you. He says he still uses carbon copies, you know, carbon paper in the office. And I'm like, press hard, two copies, last one's yours, baby. I know that. Okay, I started long enough where we use the carbon copy. There's nothing wrong with that. But only do what you know when it comes to technology. So some of you are going to fake it till you make it. You've heard that term before. But don't practice in front of your clients. Like, we're going to talk a lot about video today. Don't practice in front of your clients. Practice at the office, practice whatever it is, whatever tech you want to start implementing in your business. Only do what you know. I can tell you, I picked up a client last week because they went to work with an agent in the office, a nice office, really techy and stuff. He didn't know how to turn on the Bluetooth mouse. Let that sink in for a second. He's sitting there, he's like, oh, I can't. We're going to have to reschedule. Right? What? And they're like, okay, yeah, sure, no problem. As soon as they left there, they went online and said, I need to find me a tech savvy realtor. Okay, because for them, if you're, like, they don't get it because we've grown up with technology. Right, if you can't even do that one little thing, this is a complicated process. Right, if you can't work a mouse, how are you gonna help me buy a house? I didn't even make up that rhyme beforehand. Okay, that was just off the cuff. So tech savvy, only do what you know.
Necessarily.
Who here has ever done a video? Okay, Jim, so far?
I do videos and also I'm hanging soul designs with my clients, and that's one of the times that the kids are actually hanging the sign, so they're in the video behind me, and I do it in one take. I don't do readings because I think up in the room, just kind of the normal process, it's better, and I get a lot of good feedback from that.
So I'm going to repeat what he said, paraphrase it. He hangs the soul signs, but he has the family members hang the soul signs for him. He does a video, live video, right?
Yep.
Live video, and he makes it about the client. That's the big difference. You never want to be like, hey, Jeremiah's J-Man Realty sold another house. Yeah. So awesome. Because that's not what they want to hear, right? It's like, you have to tell the story. It's always what I say. Tell the story. Like, I told this one story via live video of a client who, we're doing a final walkthrough, and she starts crying. And I'm like, oh, it's okay. Room clean condition. I mean, look at me. I don't know what's going on. And it was tears of joy. Okay, she told me that at one point, her and her family were homeless. See, I see it in all your faces. There's tears about to be. Her and her family were once homeless. And to her, like, this is the American dream of homeownership. This is what we do. It's not sales, right? I tell people I'm the architect of the American dream, baby. That's what I do, right? Nobody comes to America and says, I want to rent a house. This is a good one.
I think we're critical of ourselves. Like when I did a video, I probably have to retake that now 10 times before I'm like satisfied and send it out.
Everybody hear that? We are critical of ourselves. Here's the top two reasons. You don't like how you look, and you don't like how you sound. Newsflash, people. It's how you look. You're still doing business, right? I mean, have you ever met a client and they go, oh my God, your face. Right? Well, maybe once or twice. Right? So, but the video feels the same way. And if they reject you, at least you don't see it, right? But in person, you guys are all doing business. Nobody here is their first day. If you guys don't like me, then fine. I don't like you either. Okay? That's what I feel about it. So you don't like how you look. You don't like how you sound. We're going to help you get over that. This is going to be a little bit of an intervention today, a Dr. Phil moment, where hopefully by the end of this, you're still going to not like how you look, but you're going to get over it and just do it.
For sharing, please.
And she's saying, like, it's all tied into self-esteem, right? We're like, we don't want to be rejected, right? Because you don't know who's looking at your videos. She's saying at the closing table, she doesn't have a problem doing something at the closing because it goes to her client that she already has an existing relationship with. She's scared of the public, of the masses, who might be judging her and her video. And here's the thing, who cares? Say it with me. Who cares? Because when it comes down to it, focus on your why. Like, why do you do this? Right, I got 2 kids, 2 years old, 7 years old. If it was a matter of me doing a video and being uncomfortable or feeding my family, I'm doing a video. That's how extreme it has to be.
What's a short sale?
Does it mean it's a short closing time? Right? How can I buy a HUD home? How much money do I need for down payment? All the questions we are asked throughout the transaction, that's an opportunity to educate. Because the consumer goes online and they're doing their Google search well before they ever buy a home. So if you can create that content, you want to be following at what's called the zero moment, which are thousands of videos. But still, like, you know, Lacey asked me, she said, can you do a promo video for the conference? And I'm like, sure. Do you know how hard it is to say Minnesota Mortgage Association and Minneapolis Area Association of Realtors?
Yeah.
That's like a tongue twister by itself. I had like 20 outtakes just with that. I mean, because I have to say it right. It can't be like Minneapolis Association. It has to be Minneapolis Area Association of Realtors. So it's like, record, record, record. Here's what happened.
Millennium. Things that I don't know.
I'm like, oh, one of my favorite things, my client's late again. Right? How many people love that? I might even just send it to my clients so they know how much I enjoy it. Because you know, there should be no distinction between business and all my clients are my friends. Right? Because you build that relationship, that's where the real referrals come. It's not like this.
Of all your social media, what percent of yours is Snapchat? Honestly.
Honestly?
No.
Oh, because I was going to lie. I would say 23.7%.
Quarter of all your interactions are Snapchat.
Yeah.
Wow. Okay.
Yeah, because you got to think the whole reason why I do this. I want to raise the level of the industry across the planet. Okay? It's high aspirations, but we can do it, right? One session at a time. And so for you guys, if you have questions, I'm here to help you. I'm not trying to do it to make money. There's too many coaches in the world, not enough players. That's my own personal thing. And then the LED lights that I told you. All right, so that brings us to the end of today, but I just want to thank you guys for being awesome.
Thank
and
you.
Hope you're going to come back in the afternoon. Give yourselves a round of applause.